Hello students, in the previous video classes we have started the directory. What is directory? Basic structure, basic concept of the directory, and there are so many operations upon the directory, and that thing also we have discussed, like creation of file, because directory nothing but it contains several numbers of files. So several files are stored in a particular directory. So first of all, we can create a new file in a directory. So file creation, and also we can search, because there are so many files in a particular directory. So we can search a particular file from a particular directory. And also, we can remove whenever a file is no more required, that can be removed from that particular directory. So that the deletion of files. And we can list out all the directories. Okay, we can list out all the directories also. And also, we can rename to a particular file. A file name can be changed. Means the location, the address space, address location, address will be changed. Okay. And also we can traversal of file. We can visit, we can process, we can traverse from root towards the leaf node. That thing already we have learned in first year data structure. So all the operations on the directory, that thing also we have finished. So today we discuss more about the different logical structures. Okay, different logical structures. Different logical structures of directory. There are several logical structures of the directory are used nowadays. Some important logical structures, the structures of directory, several logical structures are used. In somewhat, one directory is used, single directory is used, we don't have any subdirectories or other directories. So in previous classes we have studied root directory, flat directory, okay, subdirectories. So directory contains number of files, and also it is a portion of the mini disk, okay, that contains the information, that contains the file, and the file contains the information. So this concept is clear, I think, to all the students. So according to our syllabus we will follow. So today we will discuss about the logical structure or directory structure that is being used in the operating system, we will discuss. So some of the directory structures having a single directory. Some of the directories having single directory. Means all files will be stored in a single directory. That is the single level directory. That is the single level directory. But all files are stored in a common directory or same directory. Then two level directory. Second one, two level directory. Where the subdirectories are there. Okay. In a root directory, there is another subdirectory. That is the two level directories are used. Then there are so many disadvantages to overcome all these disadvantages of these two types of directories. Then we are using tree structure directory, tree like structure, just like your data structure. Tree structure directory. Just like a tree. Okay. So single level directory, where all files are stored in a single directory. Whenever a directory contains a subdirectory, and that subdirectory contains the files, that is the two level directory and a single level directory. And whenever directory structures are like tree, then that is the tree structure directory. Another one is acyclic graph directory. In the data structure, we have learned the graph, the cyclic graph and acyclic graph. So directory structure can be just like a acyclic graph, not cycle. The directory structure cannot be not created a cycle, that is acyclic graph. And also there are some general graph directory. So there are several like this. There are several directory structures are there. But as for our syllabus, only we will learn these three directories according to our syllabus. So according to our syllabus, we will learn single level directory, two level directory, and tree structure directory. Okay. So now we will discuss about the single level directory with its advantages and also disadvantages. Okay. Now come to the single level directories. So, in this directory, as I told you, all files are stored in a same directory or in a directory. Means it's a very simplest one. It is a simplest directory structure. This single level directory is the simplest one. The simplest directory structure. Very simple. Because all files are stored in a single directory. That is the simplest. Simplest, all considering all directory structures, it is very simplest one. Here all files, okay, here all files are stored in a same directory. All files are stored in a directory. In the same directory. Okay, all files are contained in a common directory. Okay, in single level directory, all files must be same directory and must be unique name. Here, all files require unique name. Unique name, because file name cannot be allowed to be duplicated. Duplicated files are not allowed to store a common directory, because all files are stored in a same directory. So all should have unique file name. Okay, the system does not support here the for multi-user environment. So it may be your disadvantages. So system does not support, but this directory structure does not support multi-user environment. So this single level directory structure does not support to multi-user environment. Does not support, because a single user will get a single directory and it will store all the files. Okay, it will store all the files. So the system does not support the multi-user environment. Even a single user or a single level directory, it may find it difficult to remember the file, all file names. So too difficult. Whenever a directory contains large amount of files, so difficult to remember. Difficult to remember all file names when a directory contains large number of files. Okay, so here a single directory contains all the files. So whenever number of files will be increased, so difficult to remember. Okay, so this is all about the single level directory. And if you draw the structure, suppose this is the directory. So this is the directory, like suppose this is the directory like cat test date, cat test. This example already given on your description. Date, mail, root, record. All like this. This is the directory. And it contains the file. It contains the files. These are the files. This one another file. So it's file F1. Okay, so file F1, yeah, then another file F2, this one another file suppose, F3, another file suppose, F4, another F5, F6, and so on. So these are the file structure. Okay, so it contains all the files, and this is the directory, this is a common directory, this is a root directory, you can call it the root directory. Okay, so a single directory contains all the files. Okay, a single directory contains all the files. Okay, so this is all about the single level directory. Here, one thing is that name collision may arise. Name collision may occur. And all files name is required to be unique and doesn't support the multi-user environment. Okay, so this is the single level directory. Now we'll discuss about the advantages and disadvantages of this single level directory. Now see advantages and disadvantages of this single level directory. The advantages. What are the advantages we are getting benefited from the single level directory? So in single level directory, one thing, most important thing has to be remember that all files are contained in a common directory. Means a directory contains all files. Okay. So since it is a single directory, so it is implementation is very easy. So as it is single directory, easy implementation. Easy implementation. You can implement very easily. Commonly, very simplest form of directory structure. A very simple one. Okay, because all files are contained in the same directory. Okay, if the file are smaller in size, then search will be faster. Searching faster, become faster. Searching become faster when size of the file is small. When small file. Whenever files, size of the files become smaller, then searching operation will be faster. Okay, searching operation will be faster. And the operations like creation, searching, deletion, updation are very easy. So all operations, file operations, okay, all file operations like in insertion, deletion, updation, is all operations are easily handled, easily controlled, are very easy. All operations are very easy, are easy. So this is the important note to be written for the advantages part of the single level directory. Now we will discuss about the disadvantages. So what are the limitations? Okay, what are the limitations? What are the drawbacks of this single level directory? Okay, so there is a whenever a file, a directory contains all the files, so name collision may arise. Okay, name collision may arise because two files may have the same name. So possibility of, probability of name collision may occur. Name collision may occur whenever two files have a common name. Sometimes it may be arise. Sometimes it may be arise when two files are having common name. So name collision may arise. Okay. And another thing is that searching will become time taking if the directory is large. So searching operation faster. File is small, but searching will be little bit of difficult. Okay. Searching become time taking. Searching is time taking whenever number of files are more. Whenever number of files are more or directory is large, time taking for larger directory. Larger directory means whenever a directory contains large number of files. Okay, large number of files. So time taking, searching operation will be time taking. Okay, so, for example, suppose just imagine whole world become a single state. Just imagine the whole world will be single state. So too difficult to identify the particular for searching to identify people. Another example I can give, suppose in your state there is only one district. So what will happen? So in your we can see in a different district village name may be duplicated. Suppose XY village name XYZ belongs to Katagar district, and same XYZ belongs to Ganjam district, same XYZ belongs to Kandhamal district. So it may be identified. There will be no problem. But if you contain only single district, then all village name must be unique. Okay. So partition is required. For that we are this type of problem may occur in single level directory. Though it is simplest one, so it is a time taking whenever directory size or directory structure became large. Okay. And also we cannot group the same type of files together. Okay. Another disadvantage may be we cannot group two similar types of files cannot be grouped. Okay, this is the advantage. And also it does not support to multi-user environment. Okay, does not support to multi user environment. So these are the disadvantages and advantages of the single level delivery. Okay, so easily implementation advantage, searching faster when small file advantages, different operation will be done easily, zip carrier advantages. And disadvantages, name collision may arise whenever name may be duplicated, and the searching time taking whenever directory becomes large, and cannot group to similar type of files, you cannot group because all are in a single directory, and also doesn't support to multi-user environment. Okay, so we can write what is a directory structure, logical directory structure, as a single level directory structure. We can draw the diagram, okay, common diagram, common directory containing all the files and the advantages and disadvantages. Okay, now we will see next one. Two-level directories. Two-level directories. Whenever a single-level directory contains large number of files, so it may be difficult. So we can again divide that directory to subdirectories. Means a directory contains subdirectories. Okay. So in this directory structure,